$500 billion investment in AI. Today, I want to talk about what this $500 billion will do and its impact on tech jobs. Now, when I listened to the announcement, there were a few things that I actually heard. One was I heard building new data centers, and I heard its impact on real estate, and I heard a lot of AI. So let's talk about what that means and what it's going to take to actually make this possible, to actually truly create a $500 billion AI investment. It's going to take a lot of infrastructure and all the things necessary to make that infrastructure work. Networking, servers, storage, security. And let's talk about the kinds of people that are going to be needed to design it, build it, create it, and even operate and maintain it. Now, when we come up with a massive scale project, the first thing we need are the people that can look and say, okay, here's what's available to us. What is potentially achievable? What are the business goals we're looking for? How do we want to get this done? How do we want to make it work? How are we going to create our enforce architectural standards? What kind of governance does this system sort of need? How do we maintain it? What's necessary from a change management perspective? We're going to need a lot of these people, and they're called enterprise architects. And the enterprise architect is that executive architect that's going to kind of spearhead many of these things. And we're going to need large teams of enterprise architects. So enterprise architects are going to be big winners here. But it's not just enterprise architects. Now let's talk about the actual infrastructure people, which is exciting to me because that's initially my background. So what does this mean? The infrastructure that's necessary to build a data center means that the first thing we need is really good networking people. Network architects, network engineers, people with good, strong skills. Because if we're going to build a data center, nothing's going to work without the network. And the network will determine how big that can scale, how reliable the system potentially can be, because it's the primary infrastructure. That means we will need strong people in the networking perspective. We will also need good compute and storage people. The type of people that can design the compute infrastructure, what do the servers need to look like, what type of processors do we need to have, what type of coprocessors or accelerators like GPUs do we need in these systems, how much DRAM do we need in these systems, what kind of storage and storage performance do we need. So we'll need good server people as well as good storage area network people and other storage people to make this work. So storage architects, compute architects, storage engineers, and professionals. Now, security. Now, security may have been one of the hottest fields in technology already. And there are such massive critical shortages. One of the most recent statistics is that in the U.S. alone, we're short 750,000 people, according to Forbes. So that was before this. Now, $500 billion of AI will need massive, massive security. Because if somebody hacks into an AI system with $500 billion of compute and power behind it, and infrastructure, it could be catastrophic. I mean, this thing could be turned into a weapon. It could be turned into a machine. So we're going to need very robust security on this, which means plenty of security architects, cloud security architects, lots and lots of cybersecurity professionals of all kinds, meaning people that are experts on IAM architects, for example, people that are experts on zero trust, which would again fall into your security architect role, people that are familiar with all the different types of security, meaning some people that have specialties in data loss prevention and versus others that have specialties in network security versus SIEM systems. Huge, huge, huge amount of here. Now, I'm going to talk about the multi-cloud architect here because they're really going to be needed. And here's what I mean. We're building private data centers, but nobody's going back to the old days of a data center where you got a whole bunch of servers. All of our data centers at this point are hyper-converged, just like a cloud provider, and they have the benefits of the function as a service like we love in cloud computing, like a Lambda function or an Azure function. We can do that in our private clouds, which means in our data center. Application virtualization, like application hosting, virtual machines, containers, container orchestration, compute and resource pooling. We love that. It's the agility of the cloud. So we're going to have a tremendous need for multi-cloud architects. Architects that can design these private clouds, which again was why I've been teaching multi-cloud architecture to all of our architects since the beginning, because we know a lot of businesses build by private clouds, but also the people that will know how to connect these clouds to other clouds when necessary. So lots of jobs for multi-cloud architects, good, exciting times for multi-cloud architects, and of course, multi-cloud engineers that are really good, that are really strong, that can make this multi-cloud work. Now, the obvious one is we're going to need a lot of AI people. And that's why I saved it for last, because it was the most obvious. We will need a tremendous amount of AI architects. We will need good, strong AI engineers. We will need data scientists. We will need big data architects. We will need big data engineers. Now, these are the primary people that are going to benefit, although there's others that will benefit as well. Now, also, when it comes to building multiple data centers, it also takes a lot of people to keep these systems up and operational. It takes power people. It takes HVAC people. It takes hands that can get on these boxes, swap hard drives, if you will, replace parts, deal with break fix issues. So that opens up a lot of opportunities that have been recently lost for people that do these data center type technician roles. And they've been recently lost because many people have gone just purely into cloud computing. Well, not many, but some companies have. And as they've reduced their data center staff, it doesn't take as many of these technicians at the cloud providers as it normally would in a data center, because the cloud provider, they can aggregate all the things for many customers and not need quite as many people. But if we're going back to the private data center, that means we're going to need more hands and more technicians and more people to do the work, which is, again, good jobs for the people that have been involved in these compute type technician fields, people that are running the cabling, doing the power, doing the cooling. So I think that's good too. Now, obviously, there's some tech companies that probably benefit here as well. We can all think of who they are. I think companies like Nutanix and IBM will benefit from their private clouds. I think AMD and NVIDIA will both benefit from their GPUs. I think AMD and Intel will also benefit from their CPUs. We've got networking companies like Cisco and others that will probably benefit from the network infrastructure that's going to be built with this $500 billion. We've got security companies like Palo Alto Networks and Cisco that, again, and I don't mention Cisco twice because they're in multiple categories, that I think can benefit hugely here. Now, we've got our big, you know, compute technology companies like IBM and HP and Dell, big in compute, storage, that kind of thing, and even networking to a degree. I see them having a big win here. Now, also, if you heard the speech last night, you heard Larry Ellison speak. And you heard Larry Ellison, who was the Oracle CEO, speak about healthcare. Now, what most people don't realize is Oracle actually owns Cerner, which is a huge healthcare electronic health record company, which actually powers the U.S. Veterans Administration's healthcare systems. So you can see Oracle is going to be here from a healthcare perspective, but they're also a pretty big database, big data company, and they've got a lot of cloud computing power. So getting them heart and central kind of looks pretty shiny and good for Oracle, although time will tell. Historically, the U.S. government does a lot of business with Microsoft, so most likely Microsoft will benefit here. The question becomes how much of this stuff will go to public cloud providers, and time will tell to see who benefits from that absolutely as well. And then, of course, the other side of this, and there are other people that benefits, but these are what immediately come top of mind, are the people that can provide power. All of this stuff is going to take a lot of power. It's going to take a lot of cooling, which means HVAC systems, but it's going to take a lot of power. And that means it's going to need some form of power investment. Either these organizations do what the big cloud providers are doing, which is they start building their own nuclear power plants, or there's opportunities to create more power to power these systems. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I saw this $500 billion AI investment, and I wanted to talk about all the careers that are going to benefit, not just the AI, because I want you to know that you can do what you love, and this is still one of the best opportunities I've seen in the last few decades. Now, if you want to become an AI architect or a network architect or a cloud architect or a security architect or an enterprise architect, join us for a completely free webinar. We'll go over the roles. We'll talk about what we do. We'll talk about the skills for these things, and of course we'll answer any questions live on Zoom, completely free to assist you in your technology career. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in a new video or a new webinar. Take care.